Barcelona have lost their identity and philosophy under Ernesto Valverde. The club under Valverde has suffered two of their most humiliating defeats, the first one in Rome against Roma and the second one at Anfield against Liverpool. But even after all that, somehow Ernesto Valverde is still the coach of Barcelona. This season especially, Barcelona looked clueless. Just last weekend, they lost to Levante away 3-1, and then in the Champions League at their Camp Nou, they struggled to score against Slavia Prague. It's crazy to say this, but they seem even more dependent on Leo Messi than ever before. So I thought it'd be really interesting to compare Valverde's Barcelona to Pep Guardiola's Barcelona, which by the way, many regard as the best club side of all time. I think this would be a great way to show you guys how far ahead Pep Guardiola's tactics and style of play was in comparison to Valverde's. So this is how these experiments work. We're going to be putting these two teams, Valverde's Barça up against Pep's Barça in a computer versus computer match to find out which team comes out on top. So if you guys do enjoy these experiment style videos, make sure to drop a like on this one. And also if you are new around here, subscribe for more FIFA 20 content. And also, let me know what experiments we should be doing next. Today's video is sponsored by OneFootball, which in my opinion is the best football news app out there. You can get your live score updates, transfer news, basically everything related to your favorite football club. And you can even get notifications to, you know, keep yourself updated at all times. And you know what's the best part? This app is completely free on both iOS and Android. So what are you waiting for? Download the OneFootball app now by using the link in the description below. First up, let's take a look at Valverde's Barcelona. Now, I'm basing the team around this season's Barcelona team. So you've got the likes of Griezmann and Frenkie de Jong involved. Formation-wise, Valverde has gone with a 4-3-3 this season. Funnily enough, although Valverde tries to play a 4-3-3 formation, on the pitch, it is completely different. Especially in that game against Slavia Prague. At one point, Barcelona had two defenders, one midfielder and six attackers. I swear even Sunday league teams don't even play with a formation and tactics like that. It is actually embarrassing. Alright, let's now take a look at the team. First up, we've got the team's captain, Leo Messi. Many would argue that he's the reason why Valverde is still there because he's been bailing out Valverde with his unbelievable performances. And that's why Barcelona have managed to win La Liga twice under Valverde. It's been all because of Leo Messi. Of course, you've got Luis Suarez as well up top. This season though, his level has been really tragic. He's just got injured as well now. Antoine Griezmann, the new signing that Barcelona made to ease the load on Messi and Suarez, well, Valverde playing him out wide hasn't really worked out well for him. He is struggling. A midfield of Arthur, Busquets and Frenkie de Jong is what Valverde has been using this season. And at the back, we've got the likes of Jordi Alba, Longley, Piqué and Semedo forming the back line. Their defense has been so suspect this season. And of course, Marc-Andre Ter Stegen in goal. On the bench, Valverde has got some decent options in Ousmane Dembele, Ivan Rakitic, who was one of his favorite players at a time, but now he's moved on to Arthur and de Jong. Vidal as well, who's been decent for Barcelona in some games. Paulinho is an interesting one. I decided to include him because of how heavily used he was under Valverde in that one season where he was signed from China. Such a weird signing, but funnily enough, it did work. Sergio Roberto, Umtiti and Neto as well completing the bench. Imagine having all this talent and struggling so much on the pitch. It's crazy, man. Valverde needs to be gone. But anyways, this is the team we're going to be using for the experiment. Now, I don't know what tactics to use for Valverde's team, so I'm keeping it on balanced and balanced because let's be honest, on the pitch, they are just so random. Everyone's out of position. It really makes no sense. So I'm just going for balanced and balanced. Messi's going to captain Valverde's team. Of course, he's going to be taking free kicks and penalties as well and sharing the corner duties with Arthur. Alright, it is now time for the fun stuff. We're taking a look at Pep Guardiola's Barcelona and I've tried to recreate the 2011 Champions League winning side. And because I'm on the PC version, I've managed to get icons involved in today's video, so Carlos Puyol is going to captain this Barca team. The iconic false nine formation is what we're going to be using in this video. Also, I had to create a few players like Xavi, Abidal and Dani Alves and even Victor Valdez because they are not in FIFA, so I've tried to make them look as realistic as possible. So here we have Pep's team with Messi playing in the hole in that center forward position. David Villa on the left side and Pedro on the right. What an efficient attack that was. In midfield, we've got quite possibly the greatest midfield of all time with Sergio Busquets, Andres Iniesta and Xavi Hernandez. It was basically impossible to get the ball off this midfield. They were that good. Moving on to the defense, Abidal was Barca's left back back then. Gerard Pique, one of their centre backs, along with Puyol. Talking about Puyol, man. Imagine if Barca had a presence at the back like Puyol right now. How crazy would that be? But he's going to be captaining the team. Dani Alves as their fullback on the right and Victor Valdes in goal. On the bench, have included a few players that Pep coached over his entire time at Barcelona. So Thierry Henry from 2009 and 10, Ibrahimovic from 2010. We've got Afellay and Boyan as some of the bench options. Thiago as well played a few games under Pep. Mascherano played a big part under Pep's Barcelona. And we've got this Oyer guy as well as one of the backup keepers for Barcelona back then. Obviously, I could have included Henry or Ibrahimovic in the team, but I wanted to replicate the 2011 Barcelona side. So David Villa, Messi and Pedro in attack. Pep's Barcelona was all about applying pressure high. And well, press after possession loss is the perfect defensive tactic. Possession-based attacking football. And this is how we're going to have Pep's Barca playing in today's video. Carlos Puyol is going to captain Pep's team with Messi taking free kicks, sharing it with Xavi as well. Messi's going to take penalties with Xavi taking corners. It is now time to put these two teams in a computer versus computer match. Valverde's Barcelona up against Pep Guardiola's Barcelona. If this would happen in real life, there would only be one winner, and that's Pep's team. But let's see who's going to win in FIFA. So here we go, it is Pep Guardiola's Barcelona up against Valverde's Barcelona. Now, logic says there should be only one winner, and for me, that is Pep's team. But this is FIFA, and anything can happen. So Valverde's team is wearing the home jersey, and I've got Pep's team wearing the brand new third kit. Here's Carlos Puyol on the ball. It's always brilliant seeing him once again in a Barcelona jersey. 20 minutes in and I've got to say, Valverde's team has managed to hold their own. They're keeping possession really well, which is a bit funny. And it could be a chance for Busquets on the volley. He almost scored there. Victor Valdes coming up clutch with a brilliant save. Sergio Busquets taking volleys from outside the box. Yep, FIFA doesn't make that much sense. Valverde's team with maybe another chance as Frenkie de Jong lets a shot off from outside the box, but Victor Valdes had that one covered. Here's Andres Iniesta, always beautiful seeing him in that midfield for Barcelona as he's pushing forward with the help of Xavi, but Gerard Pique this time stopped Andres Iniesta in his tracks. Busquets in behind to Andres Iniesta, could be the first opportunity for this game for Pep's team as he lays this one off to Leo Messi. Can he get there? He can! And Leo Messi opens the scoring for Pep Guardiola's Barcelona. Just like how it happened all those years ago, Messi again performing for Pep's team. Andres Iniesta picking up the assist for that goal. The way Iniesta got in behind the Barcelona defense was actually crazy good. The cutback was decent. Pique got a touch to it, but Messi got there first ahead of course, Ter Stegen. Converted it, and there you go, guys. Pep Guardiola's team have taken the lead in the 31st minute of this one. Pep's team on the attack once again with Leo Messi keeping possession really well. Again, Messi getting involved in midfield. That was the point of the false nine, with Messi dropping deep, creating chances and also moving forward for the attacks. As now David Villa is looking to push forward for Pep's team. Abidal back to Villa. Look at how well this team is keeping possession, man. Valverde's team needs to respond, and Frenkie de Jong could be doing that for them. Of course, now Messi back into Frenkie de Jong, but Eric Abidal so strong as a fullback there to stop Frenkie de Jong in his tracks. Brilliant defending from the Frenchman. Pep's team once again on the attack as Leo Messi is 1v1 against Longley. There can only be one winner in that fight as Messi beats Ter Stegen once. And on the rebound, a simple header for Leo Messi as he's destroying Valverde's team. Barcelona lead 2-0 now. Pep's team, of course. And again, it is Leo Messi that strikes. We all know how influential and important Messi was for Pep's team and just how obscenely good he was up front in terms of goals and assists. And he's doing exactly that in this experiment as he's scored both goals so far as Pep's team lead 2-0 before halftime. I guess this was expected, but my God, man, Valverde's team is just getting destroyed. Halftime, and so far it's been all Team Pep. We need to see something incredible in that second half from Valverde's team, but I don't think they've got that in them. I think it's going to be more goals for Team Pep in the second half. Let's see what happens. Messi now looking to push forward, and the team in blue and red on the attack. Nelson Semedo now. Can he put in a cross? Again, Semedo lacking the end product there, but maybe he can still do something. Goes back to Busquets. Sergio Busquets finds Frenkie de Jong. Now it's Leo Messi, but Pique with a strong challenge, and Sergio Busquets letting it go from outside the box. I've got to say, I find it funny that Valverde's best chances so far in this game have come from Sergio Busquets of all players. It's now Messi, now Frenkie again, inside to Luis Suarez, and that was the chance for Valverde's team to get back into the game. Oh well, not really, because it was offside. So Pep's team still leading 2-0, but what? What am I seeing? Leo Messi being substituted by Pep Guardiola? I know it's Thierry Henry that's being brought on, but that is extremely weird. Well, Pep, that might cost you. That might really cost you. Here's Griezmann again. He's been completely absent in this game, playing it down that left flank. Although he's played in a good pass into Jordi Alba. Can Alba do something? He's taken it too wide, and there goes the chance. Valverde's team look clueless even on FIFA. Here's Arthur, finds Antoine Griezmann, back into Arthur. Team Valverde still trying their best to get back into this game. Oh well, Griezmann's gone past Dani Alves, sends him to the ground as well. Still Griezmann, now Arthur, could go for goal, does go for goal, but Victor Valdez with a great save. Oh, Ivan Rakitic has been brought on as well for Team Valverde, plays in a good pass into Vidal, but Valdez making another great save. Rakitic and Vidal almost combined to score a goal there. Here's Andres Iniesta taking the ball wide, beats one, whips in a fantastic cross. Xavi with the header. You normally don't see him in those kind of positions, but he couldn't keep that one on target. Team Valverde might have one chance to at least get something on the score sheet, as it's Leo Messi pushing forward, finds Rakitic, and of all the people to score a goal, it is Ivan Rakitic. I mean, it's poetic that it's Rakitic that tries and saves Valverde. They both love each other, I guess. As you guys can see, Leo Messi laying it off to Rakitic, and well, Team Valverde have got something to cheer for at least, as they do manage to get one goal past Victor Valdez, and it's Ivan Rakitic on the score sheet. And that is that for today's experiment. Team Pep Guardiola have come out on top, which I guess was expected. They've got the better team, the better tactics as well. Messi scoring a brace for Pep's team, of course. Rakitic getting one for Valverde. I've got to say, Team Valverde did put up a fight, which was surprising. Had a big question for you guys. What do you all think about the current Barcelona situation? Should Valverde be sacked? Let me know in the comments section. For me, it has to happen. But anyways, that is it for today's experiment video. Really hope you guys have enjoyed this one. If you guys did, drop a like in the video. Subscribe if you are new around here. And I'll catch you guys next time.